biostatistician have in saving sea turtle habitats? And what does a water pump in London in the 1800s have to do with biostatistics? And once a pharmaceutical is on the market, how does a biostatistician quantify whether a drug is safe and effective? High school students in Miami learned the answers to these and other questions during the spring of 2011 as part of an annual meeting of the biostatisticians. Biostatisticians attending this conference gave talks in several high schools in Miami about their specific research interests as well as general advice about career opportunities in statistics. Our intent through that outreach in this presentation is to interest young people to pursue a career in statistics. On behalf of ENAR and the American Statistical Association, we present a few clips of those high school classroom talks about career opportunities in statistics and provide information about what is biostatistics and how I can become a biostatistician.
Who hires biostatisticians? Anybody who has data and wants to do the right thing should hire a biostatistician.
I'm a professor at Emory University in Atlanta, in Georgia. I teach in a School of Public Health. School of Public Health, we mostly teach master's and doctoral students. We have a few undergraduates. And what I'm going to talk to you today is how did I end up becoming a statistician, why I like what I do, and I'm going to talk about one of the projects in particular. It's my favorite project I've ever worked on. Statisticians don't ever work alone. Somebody's always collecting data, they've got a question, and you're trying to help them and answer that. I want to talk a little bit about what statistics means outside of AP Stat. Can you get a job doing this? Maybe you don't believe that, but you can. The best part of being a statistician is I can work with someone who works in physics, I can work with someone who's a doctor, I can work with someone who's a conservation biologist. And so the absolute best project I ever worked on was a sea turtle nesting evaluation. And so I really do think my job is I'm a scientist. I may be a statistician, but I can work in all these other fields, and I help them answer the questions they're interested in. You're taking AP Stats, so you know what you think statistics is. It could be just a set of tools. You have a chi-square test, check. I have a z-test, check. I have all these different things. I can do regression, check. Right? It's a bunch of math because there's a bunch of formulas you have to memorize, and you might have to use them in the AP exam, right? It's really a bigger thing than that. I, in high school, and most of my way through undergraduate, and probably 2 years into graduate school, did well in school because I could remember things. So I would memorize that. Oh, I remember that formula. Oh, I remember we did a problem like this. This problem looks almost the same. Oh, this is a homework problem in the regression chapter. I probably should use regression. Well, once you get out in the real world, it doesn't work that way. Someone just says, here's some data, tell me what I can find. So I have a toolbox, but I didn't really understand how all the tools work. So biostatisticians, some people work alone, but not very many of us. We tend to work in groups, which I like, because I get to work with the turtle people, I learn about turtles. I get to work with the Ruli Ulcer Ministry of Health in Ghana and meet people there who are out in the front lines. They design studies like, we have a new drug, does it work better than another drug? Are we able to treat malaria better than we could before? Are we able to treat headaches better than before? They help collect the data, they analyze the data, they interpret the results and say, what questions can you answer? A lot of times people will get the p-value and answer a different question, but it's the statistician's job is to kind of keep it all clean. And you can work in a lot of medical and public health studies. So when you see the term biostatistician, people are usually talking about public health or medical studies. So who hires biostatisticians? Well, anybody who's got data and wants to do the right thing should hire a biostatistician.
What do biostatisticians do on a day-to-day basis? Biostatisticians work in collaborative groups to design studies, process and analyze data, and interpret results concerning a wide range of medical and public health studies. So biostatisticians such as Dr. Lance Waller from Emory University can help determine the impact of a beach construction on sea turtle nesting sites. We can help determine if certain pacemakers have increased rates of complications. Or we may be involved in projects to determine the effectiveness of HIV treatments. Dr. Norman discusses biostatistics examples, including applications to healthcare policy.
Statistics and biostatistics are very closely related. It so happens that the biostatistic field focuses more on the biological aspects of things, and that actually has opened up. So you can think of medicine, you can think of how good is your environment, is there a lot of pollution in the air, that is also studied in biostatistics. You can think about animal life and looking at whether or not the seas are being depleted of fish and how turtles are doing, that's also biostatistics. So it's a field where there's more of an emphasis in terms of application areas. And I happen to go in an area which is mostly medicine, and I'll talk about it. It's actually medicine and health policy, which I'll talk about in a second. What do I do? So I've actually shown you, I'm in Harvard Medical School, I'm in a department that's called healthcare policy. And what is that department? Well, first of all, it's the intersection of these three different fields. The first one's biostatistics. And that's really where you're looking at developing and applying statistical science to public health problems, epidemics, vaccines, clinical trials. Does anybody know what a clinical trial is? Oh, you've heard of it? So if I want to develop a new drug and see whether or not to sell it to the public, I have to see how it works. And have you learned about randomization? So if I wanted to see how it works, I have to sort of randomize some people to get drug A and some people get to drug B, and then I can see if my drug A is better than drug B or if drug A works. Now, those are clinical trials. That's when you take people, you consent them, it's safe, and you try and see whether or not a new medical therapy, whether that's a drug or a medical device or a behavioral therapy, that is... You can even think of it as anything, exercising, whether you make people exercise a lot or a little in terms of reducing weight. So that's sort of the clinical trial aspect. So lots of different things. And so that's biostatistics. I'm actually in health policy, which is a funny thing, but I actually find it very exciting. And that is the study and financing of the delivery of healthcare, quality of healthcare, and access to healthcare. Health policy really is who determines whether a hospital should be shut down. Who determines whether or not a physician group should practice? Who's good enough to meet those standards? How often should people be vaccinated in terms of the public world? Who should pay for those services?
Dr. Waller discusses the role of the biostatistician in determining the impact of construction near sea turtle nesting areas of Juno Beach, Florida.
So if you're a baby turtle and you're in the sand, you know, all you can see is sand, and you really need to get off that beach and get in the water because there's a lot of stuff that wants to eat you out here. And so they look for the lightest horizon. If that turns out to be the city, then they're, you know, going right into trouble. So that's exactly right. We're on Juno Beach up in Palm Beach County. We want to build a fishing pier. That way people don't have to go in boats. They can walk out to the end of this 1,000-foot pier and they can fish. And it'll bring a lot of people to the beach. That would be pretty cool. Also, if you own a lot of beachfront property, you don't really like the fact that the beach erodes in some places because, you know, that's eating up your property. So, and also the same beach, they were saying, we want to hire a big contracting group to build the beach back out, dredge up some sand, and make it a nice beach so we can make sure everybody's comfortable. If you're going to do construction on a beach at the scale we're talking about, a big fishing pier or dredging up lots of sand, you need to do an environmental impact statement. That's a lot of paperwork saying how what you're going to do is impacting the environment. Well, we have here satellite pictures of Juno Beach. Yeah. We may have to back up just a little. The fishing pier, we've got satellite images. You can see the beach, and I've got colored dots on them. What they would do is every morning drive down the beach, see the the turtles don't leap out of the water, sneak over here, make a nest and hide. They drag themselves up. They're designed to swim. They leave tracks, so they'll drive an ATV, they'll find the tracks, and then they'll take a GPS unit and get latitude and longitude for every track. And they'll figure out if there's a nest there, if something has dug up the eggs, whether it's a raccoon or a dog or a cat or something. What we've got here are red dots, which were right before the pier was built. We have yellow dots, which were right after the pier was built, and blue dots, which are right after the nourishment project. So the blue dots tend to be a little further out because the beach actually got wider as well. There are dots of all different colors at the pier, but what do you see around the pier?
Turtles.
Yeah, kind of a gap. But it's not that big, so you know, kind of good news, bad news. It does impact them, but maybe it's not that far. So we're going to look at some more statistics, but John Tukey is a famous statistician. You may have heard his name and some things, but his said the whole job of a statistician is to present the data in such a way you don't need statistics to understand it. So graphing, mapping, that's all part of statistics, and it's a really important part of communication, because I could go to the construction board and say, look, this is what we see. I could give them tables and tables and tables of numbers, too, and they might just kind of glaze over and say, yeah, whatever. But here, they can see what's happening where. So what we saw for both the loggerheads and the greens was a significant reduction of them coming out. Now, I said all emergences, so not whether they nested or not. On the northern portion of the nourishment project, I get a significant increase to the south. So I actually answered some more specific questions than maybe we started with. Our question was there an impact? We could actually describe the effect with statistics too.
If this type of job interests you, here are some general guidelines for preparing for a career in biostatistics. High school is not too early to begin preparing. Students should have an extremely strong mathematics background and should consider taking AP or honor calculus. Taking AP statistics in high school is helpful, but not required. In addition, you will want a strong background in science. If possible, learning a computer programming language is helpful. In college, students will need to have a very strong math curriculum. Most biostatisticians major in math, statistics, or biostatistics. Some suggested courses are listed here, as well as some that are recommended. In particular, most biostatisticians agree that having an extremely strong math background is essential. Many biostatistics and statistics jobs require a graduate degree. A graduate degree is useful for many positions, but is not always required. Typical graduate degrees can be at the master's or doctoral level. The admission criteria to graduate programs vary by school and degree, but here are some general guidelines. Graduate coursework in biostatistics may include courses in statistical programming, multiple linear regression, statistics methodology, categorical data analysis, survival analysis, Bayesian statistics, clinical trials, or longitudinal data analysis. Some of the considerations for admission to statistics or biostatistics programs include these. Excellent math abilities. Excellent scores on math SAT or math GRE. Excellent grades in math courses. Experience in programming languages. For biostatistics programs rather than statistics, collaborative experience in a health-related field, such as working on public health study, is helpful. Sign me up, says Dr. Waller. According to the chief economist at Google, statistician is the dream job of the next decade.
So by now you think this is so fantastic, you're ready to sign up and be a statistician. So how do you go about doing that? And how would you... I would be remiss if I didn't encourage you into a career, because I do think it's a great thing to do. So the last part here that's in your handout are just some overviews of what kind of jobs are there for biostatisticians. Some of the cool jobs are, I think, things like a sea turtle work. I saw a job ad for a dolphin epidemiologist. They wanted someone to do health studies on dolphins in Charleston, South Carolina. And if I didn't already have a job, I'd swear to me. I had a job ad that circulated for someone to work for the International Criminal Court in The Hague. So you'd be processing more criminal crimes because people would be bringing in data on mass exodus, where people go. That's fascinating, important, really hard work to do. So what do biostatisticians do? How do you train to be one, and what kind of job can I get? And then probably, how much does it pay? One of the guys who works for Google, so statisticians love this quote because it's the first time in the world that the word statistician sexy has been in the same sentence. But he was interviewed a couple years ago, and he said, this is the big job of the future. We're collecting more data than ever before. We measure all this stuff, and we have no idea what to do with all these measurements. We graph it sometimes. Google's collecting every click you do and all that. He says people think you're joking, but the ability to take data, understand it, process it, extract value, find questions, draw graphs, communicate it to somebody else is a hugely important skill. The New York Times said it's one word for college graduates was statistics. Take more statistics classes, because to get around in the world, you need to be able to understand when someone's telling you something that's true or based on data or something that's true.
A common question for someone exploring careers in statistics is, what are the salaries? This information is available from a variety of sources, including reports by the American Statistical Association. But first, here is what others have said on this topic. From an article in the journal Nature, today, biostatistics offers lucrative salaries in a variety of projects that go beyond simple number crunching, and yet few people in the scientific community are aware of it. Couple those numbers, the salaries, with a high job satisfaction of ever-changing projects and brushing up on your math doesn't sound so bad. You have real impact, says Dr. Normand. Personally, I find it very rewarding. You are needed everywhere.
So your task today was not to talk about the statistical work in terms of the detailed theory and formula and all that kind of stuff. We do that. I'm not, that's my bread and butter, is to do that. But I wanted to emphasize that you work with lots of different people, you work on different applications. My applications are in the medical and public health area, and so I talked a little bit about that, and I talked about the actual impact real life. You know, what is a reformulation? How do I get health insurance? What's a good hospital? Should I get a medical device? What do I need to know? And so you actually have real impact in terms of what you do. You do things that have impact. And I just, it's personally, I find it very rewarding. Now, it's also monetarily, you can do well also in the field of statistics and biostatistics. They range from salaries in terms of whether you have a PhD or a master's, whether you're a manager or non-manager, but these are just averages. And so, you know, there's variation on the low and the high end in terms of the salary ranges. But this is to say that currently, even in the market right now, economic downturn, we are still lots and lots and lots of jobs for statisticians because, in fact, you need it everywhere. And it's a field, I think, that has tremendous amount of impact, whether it's in environmental health, in economics, in business. And I guess my area of love is health.
A front-page story in the New York Times reported in August 2009. The rising stature of statisticians who can earn $125,000 atop companies in their first year after getting a doctorate is a byproduct of the recent explosion of digital data. Another quote from this article, "She's an internet-age statistician, one of many who are changing the image of the profession as a place for drone-ish number nerds. They are finding themselves increasingly in demand and even cool." In conclusion, careers in statistics or biostatistics can be rewarding and interesting. Learn more about these careers through these websites. Thank you to statisticians giving talks within Miami high schools. Thank you to the high schools and teachers participating in the project. The project was funded by the ASA Biometrics Section. We conclude this quote from the chief economist for Google. Remember, statistician is the dream job of the next decade.